Is that the
Please.
easy
That's a
game?
battle
plan?
plan.
All right.
Please.
Opt into a land.
Please.
Ding. Oh,
Yes.
yes. All right.
Yes.
So land,
Yes.
play
Yes.
this,
Yes.
shock them, and then unleash fury. And that's the turn four win. That's the turn four win that we've been getting just consistently every single time. Hit
Yeah.
you for 20.
Broken
Don't even
deck.
worry about it.
Oh.
Bam. This deck's broken. Welcome to the new historic. Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena with me, Righty Knight, and joining me this week and every week, Torolf Topple Sever, the big champion.
What?
And Jamin Cal.
That's J-A-M-I-N.
Ooh.
Speedrun. Speedrun. Wow, beautiful. All right, let's get to it, boys. Let's talk about this dumb deck that we're going to play, and then we'll get underway with the games. We're playing a deck called No Blocks, because that's what we want to hear our opponents say here. This deck is designed to punish anyone who doesn't respect Kiln Fiend. You play Kiln Fiend, you attack with it, and if they don't block it, you can go Infuriate plus Raking Claws or Infuriate plus Unleash Fury, and that's lethal. That'll just kill them.
It's a Trojan doggy. You go like, oh, that's a cute dog. I don't... Oh, no.
Yeah, exactly. And it just absolutely tears
can
their
face off. Can we get more of the Topple slobbering sound?
That's the content people crave. People love it. So in order to try to get this fellow through, we've got our old friend, actually. We've got Tetsuko Umezawa.
The messenger!
The post officer, who we haven't played with her for a long time. It's good to have her back.
Yeah.
And she not only makes the Kiln Fiend unblockable, but also the Dreadhorde Arcanist, which is going to be sweet because all of the stuff that we play is an instant. So, for example, we can go Kiln Fiend, attack, make it unblockable, go Samet Sprint to give it haste. We just have to do it really fast, right?
it's like 5D chess where you can give it haste in the past.
Yes, exactly. That's what we're doing.
Did you ever see the explanation of 5D chess? I didn't get it.
Topple, you'll be surprised to learn I did not even bother. Like, even 2D, 1D chess is a little
beyond me. It basically works that you can checkmate yourself in the past.
Of course.
It's very interesting, but also I didn't get it.
Yeah, no. Even I think 1D chess is plenty for me. Anyway, so look, we're going to see how it goes. Basically, the idea is we play a Kiln Fiend and hope that they just don't block, and then we can immediately punish them. This deck is super
if they
swingy.
Block, we're really just out of stuff to do. Like,
yeah, if we block, it's like, all right. Because this doesn't get toughness. Like, if they block, it's just dead most of the time. So, anyway.
We'll one time we can play Infuriate and they probably survive it. But then it's a typical, okay, I block. Oh,
Okay.
I premise for, like, all the other events.
but not this one. Yeah, exactly. Oh, dear. Anyway. Before we begin, of course, a message from our sponsor, who this week is channelfireball.com. Did you like the this week? It sounds like we have different
sponsors.
Yeah,
it's really good.
It sounds like we have many options.
Many different options. But this week we've decided to go with channelfireball.com, and we thank them for their support and patronage this week, as we do more or less every week, but we'll leave that alone. Let's talk a little bit about our sponsor for this week, channelfireball.com. I'm reading here that they are a purveyor of magic cards. Okay.
Whatever that is.
If you want to go, pardon?
A purveyor?
A purveyor. Yes, they purvey these things. I don't know what the difference between selling and purveying is. I imagine with purveying, there's a lot more sort of show, a lot more showmanship. You know,
it really makes you sound 200% more douchey.
Wow, interesting. Because I thought it was more of a, you know, like an old timey snake oil salesman. Like someone going, come and see this wonderful product. Like that sort of thing. That's purveying.
Mm.
Right? But no, Toffle's gone straight for a shirtless, backwards capped, fake tanned Jersey boy.
Yeah. No. It's more like a insurance person who's here like, hey, do you want some insurance? And you go like, no.
hey, you want to, can I purvey you some substances of questionable origin?
It's like they they throw some words that you have never heard, so you think they're fancy. And
right, okay. Legit. Well, maybe I should avoid calling them purveyors, because that's certainly what Channel 5 are doing. Buying and selling magic cards, they will do both of those things, and it's pretty straightforward, really. I mean, if you're not familiar with the concept of buying and selling, I don't really know what to tell you. Like, how have you made it this far, I guess? Like, do we need to...
But they don't only, like, buy and sell. Like, they have sick deals. Did you see what they do for spoiler season?
Oh, yes.
Actually, oh, yeah.
This is very good. All right.
They sell, like, 10 copies or some of every rare and mythic for 1 cent.
Yeah. I just don't, like, every time,
right?
Yeah, they sell 5 copies, and you only buy one. So, like, any rare and mythic that's been previewed, you go to channel5.com/spoilers, and if you're the first one there or in the first 5, you can buy it for a cent. I just don't know how to make any money. Like, they keep doing all these really cool things. Like, yeah, how do you make any money? Idiots. What are they doing?
That's not our problem.
It's not our
actually,
problem.
Like, our it is in our problem, not your viewers' problem, but...
Okay. Well, yeah, in the long run,
goes broke, they might not be able to sponsor the next episode of Arena Boys.
Yeah.
Well, so... until that gravy train runs dry, we're going to be slurping up the gravy like there's no tomorrow. Go and punish channel5.com for their foolish marketing campaigns. Go and buy, you know, the very best the best mythic in Zendikar for a cent.
I also don't get how that works. Like, you look at a preview card and then they go like, wow, I wonder what it is in my commander deck. And is there any combo to it? And then that like time frame already 500 people bought that card.
No, you've just got to set up like an alert on your phone as soon as they just bam, go and get it. Because I mean you're never losing money on that deal, right? You're never losing money on buying a rare for a cent. Anyway. Channel5.com, go and punish them for their foolish mercantile ways. And right now we're gonna punish our opponents for their foolish no block. I tried.
No, it was good. It was good.
Back in Diamond, boys, because the season is obviously reset.
Wow.
Well,
still against
okay. Excuse me. We're Diamond 4, and we're being played against the 27th best player in the world.
This is an Arena Boys first.
Is that the highest that you ever played against?
I actually think it is.
Ooh, nice.
All right.
And we have to mulligan.
Push them.
So let's keep it.
Oh, dear.
Oh, wow.
Oh, dear. Okay. All right.
We should rename the deck no keeps.
No keeps. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. No keeps.
I mean, if we win this, they will drop a fair amount.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. We're going to kick it back to gold.
This is like ancient stuff, right? Where we take their place if we win, right? That's how it works.
Right. Yeah, yes. This exactly. is the for those who've been watching my Crusader Kings streams. So I don't know. Do you guys know about Crusader Kings?
Well, I listened to 1.5 hours of intro before falling asleep.
Yes. Yeah. It's not a game for everyone for sure, but it basically you control a historical dynasty through. Ooh.
All right. And they play green, so like, there's no way they can answer this.
That's good.
Absolutely impossible.
Anyway, yeah. So you can like assassinate kings and popes and princes and that sort of stuff. And Megan, I was trying to fight a war with this king, and Megan's like, "Why don't you just assassinate the king?" And I'm like, "Okay, what would that achieve? Because then his son will take over." And then she goes, "No, you get it." I'm like, "What?" She goes, "If you assassinate a king, then you get the kingdom." And I'm like,
"Yes."
So I said, "Okay, so if you went to like Buckingham Palace and like assassinated Queen Elizabeth, do you then expect to become the Queen of England?" She's like, "Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's how it works." So, I mean, I didn't know, but
okay. So now we press for 7.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, and play Tetsuko.
Let's just make sure they don't block. After all, this is no blocks.
This is no blocks.
All right. Attack. Infuriate this.
Oh, that was before block. No.
Before blocks.
Maybe they block.
Oh, lucky.
They didn't block.
If they'd flashed in a ginger brute or something.
We might have a problem. They cost 2. So if they use the blast zone, but no, I guess
they didn't.
No.
Wait.
Oh, you attack first, right? Yeah, everything's instant, right? So, attack.
Nice.
Oh, yes. Opt.
Blocker. Next to blockers.
Next to blockers. No blocks. No blocks. Okay, here we go. We're going to get to Mythic straight away. Oh, no.
Wait.
So, at the moment, this is 5.
So, if we shock the goose now, right, then they take 8 and go to 5, and then they take... enough damage next turn.
Okay, you want to keep this?
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah, I think shocking the goose seems like a good idea.
All right,
yeah.
So keep this.
Shock the goose.
Shock the goose.
We're not winning, are we?
And then...
That would be brutal.
Beating the 27th best player on Earth with a mulligan of 5. Yes.
One time.
And they can't blast zone us either.
Hold.
Because they didn't tick up the blast zone last time.
Yeah.
They can't blast zone us. All right, Voracious Hydra.
No.
No. This is not over.
Yeah,
but they have a food token.
They have a food token now. But
okay, so I guess
just attack for one, exactly.
Well, they won't block, huh?
Yeah, but don't play Infuriate.
No.
So maybe they don't. Maybe they don't crack the food token.
Yeah, maybe they just tap out for like an Elder Gargaroth or something. Man,
maybe
imagine
they play another Hydra.
Imagine playing removal in mono green. Imagine that. I mean, that's how you get 27%. That's how you get to the 27 mythic, right?
All right.
Okay, that's
the
good.
World
that's
is a forsaken place where people play removal.
I know, it's awful. It's terrible. Imagine playing interaction.
Just play something else.
Play anything else. Just anything. No.
Okay, we just draw one. You just draw another pump spell.
Yeah.
Anyone. Any pump spell. One time.
Okay.
I've never wanted to use a one time in my life.
It's fine though. It's good. We can flash something back next turn.
Okay. All right. So attack.
So we have to use the infuriate now, right? For mana efficiency. Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe not.
No, because if they play another Hydra for 3, then we can protect the Arcanist.
Ah, sure. Very smart.
I also love how the Arcanist prevents the unblockable. That's real big brain stuff.
No, but we can play Opt.
Yeah, true.
Okay, yes, that's sure. Fine. That's fine. Yep. They go to 6.
Go to 6 and then play this.
Yeah.
Oh, this is intense, guys.
It's so close, right?
Well, it's actually more like on a broken space plane. Like, on a thing.
Broken space plane.
Yeah, it's not intense. We're not intense. This is...
Right. It's broken space plane. Like the... Okay. Sure.
All right. Yes, this is still fine, right?
So...
Also...
Wait, is it fine?
If they don't do anything else, they're dead. Because we can flashback the shock.
Okay, Vivian.
No.
No, that's okay. That's all right. We can use the Infuriate to save whatever they fight.
Yeah. Wait, do they fight? No, they damage. Right?
They damage. Yeah,
they damage.
Oh,
they don't.
Okay. Yeah, we have to.
But we have to save it.
Okay.
Okay. So we need to peel something here. We need to peel something here.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
What?
Oh.
This is ridiculous.
Okay.
They're dead.
But they're not dead. No, they're not dead. No, they go to 1.
They go to 1.
Don't block.
Okay. No blocks.
One time.
The actual worst card.
We need to. Is there anything we can opt into? Nothing deals 4 damage, huh?
No.
Damn.
Oh, we're so close. If we can opt, like, even if we opt into like a double strike or a whatever it is, you know, a double the power, that doesn't do it here because we don't have a kiln fiend.
We're not dead next turn, are we?
I don't think so. We're on 14.
We take 11.
So if we attack
13. Right now we take 13.
No, we attack. Then we play Tetsuko. We can block, right?
Oh yeah.
So what do we flash back?
Not the shock. The shock we leave for next turn.
Okay, so Infuriate.
Yeah. Okay, so just attack and Infuriate. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, attack.
Attack.
Wow, actually.
Yeah, we should have sent one at
Vivian.
Thingy. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, oops. Flashback Infuriate. We should have sent the Tetsuko. Yeah.
Oh yeah, because we're just flashing back the shock anyway. All right, doesn't matter.
Okay.
So play this. Yeah.
Oh.
Keep this one. Okay. All right. So we can block here. We're on 1. We just need to attack with the Arcanist next turn. We don't need to connect. We just need to attack.
I kind of have a bad feeling because they have like 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 mana available. 10 even with the
worst case, they can even pop Blast Zone for 2.
Oh, yeah, they can because they can
untap. We just top deck shock.
Okay, yeah, that's what they're going to do as well. Yeah, that's smart.
No.
Riley?
Yeah.
Please top deck shock that one time.
Okay. Like... Shock off the top. Okay. Yep.
So we can block, right?
Yeah, we chump the 4/4 forest.
Yeah. Chump this. I mean, they still have to crack the blast zone. Yeah. Even just for the Arcanist.
Which gets rid of all their mind stones.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Maybe they let us attack and see if we play a spell.
Yeah.
But, okay, and then a goose.
Oh, no.
Mm. Oh, that's bad.
Oh, that's, yeah, that's food. Okay.
But no, they can't crack mind blast zone and...
Of course, their forests make double mana.
Yeah, but blast zone costs 3 to activate.
Yeah.
Oh.
But we didn't top deck shock.
So. Oh,
oh, I forgot I needed to do that. Well, they also get rid of their Hydra. Oh, but we're just dead, right?
Yes, no, we're
just
dead.
Yeah, because of the Nissa. No. Man, close though, huh?
What should we have done? What did you refer to, Toffle?
What? No, no.
We should
no.
have. We, I think. Right. I think Toffle's expert game-winning line was: "We should have drawn a shock."
Yes.
Let's stay in diamond. We'll do another one in diamond. Now we're getting. Yeah. See, well, we had no chance last time. We're playing as the 27th best player in the world. Like, what chance do you actually think we had here? Man, do we keep this? We need a creature, right?
I see a problem with our deck.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we have Opt. I just wanted to point that out.
Maybe that's why they played Sprite Dragon.
Yeah, but
let's keep up.
But we cut the Sprite Dragon for the Tetsuko. So we're playing exactly the same number of creatures.
Maybe we shouldn't have done that.
All right. Well, we can put some more creatures in. But do you want to keep this hand?
No.
Yeah, easy. We'll opt into a creature. I promise you.
Oh, there we go. Much better.
Yeah, we opt into a Kill Fiend. And then we mulliganed.
Yeah. Keep.
I swear that Kill Fiend would have been in the opt.
What do you want to get
rid of? Also, it was so awkward.
Probably the shock, yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense, yeah. Because then all of our stuff is unblockable, yeah.
All of our stuff?
All of our stuff.
It was also so awkward that we had double island and mountain, so we couldn't cast shock and pump spell in the first turn.
Yeah.
Should have kept the shock.
How do you reckon our chance against a burn deck?
not great. All right, let's go up to you. Ooh.
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 I guess.
But we still need to play Kiln Fiend.
We play the Kiln Fiend this turn, yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Dangerous.
Maybe, I mean, they think it's just a 1/2. They don't read cards.
If there is a matchup where our opponents go no blocks, it's this one. Nope.
Oh.
Well, wow. They're definitely not blocking it.
I feel like we should have named our deck No Shocks.
No Shocks, yeah. No shocks, no blocks. All right, well, let's just playing.
More Kill Fiend. I mean, we just play more Kill Fiend than they have burn spells, right?
I mean, how many shocks do they play? One?
Yeah.
Probably
one.
Probably a
for
maximum
for this
one.
Case. Definitely block. They have nothing.
I mean, I should have, right? They've got a 1/2. We've got 1/2s. I definitely should have blocked.
Uh-huh.
That was really...
They're out of shocks. Now they need to cast Lightning Strikes.
Yeah. Okay.
More Kiln Fiend.
Another Kiln Fiend.
Attack first.
See if they block. Lightning strike.
Lucky.
Lucky.
Oh, now we should have played Infuriate. Bam.
No, but they still would have put three
counters on.
I know, like, but we still would have done damage. Like, because they
And then it would have died.
Exactly.
We've been pretty... Okay. We've drawn a lot of kill fiends.
They're out of shocks. Look at this. They're desperate.
They're desperate. They are. They have the attitude of someone who's playing with great desperation.
Yeah. It's like they... Yeah. Look at this. Yeah.
Yep.
No shocks.
Wow. Wasting stuff on our face.
Okay. No blocks.
Okay.
Go to 7. Yeah.
So are they dead now?
Probably not.
Can we play Tetsuko Umizawa?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then attack.
To ensure the no blocks protocol is observed.
And then shock any of the creatures?
Yeah.
I don't think probably I don't think we can shock the Soul Sky Mages.
Yeah, so Pyromancer?
Yeah. Good thing we played the Tetsuko to make sure they couldn't block, and then destroyed their blocker after they couldn't block with it.
But now we're okay, right? If they have nothing...
Yeah, if they have nothing, I mean, that's generally true, though. Another Souls.
Yeah, look at this. They have only lands.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Okay. Another shot. If we draw a land and an infuriate, right?
Well, if we draw an opt and a raking claws, right? We've got, like, we have the win in hand.
We can block, by the way.
Isn't that one short?
They're on 16. This. So that makes it 4. This makes it. Is it plus
7?
Oh, that's 7. One short, yeah, yeah, it's one short. Sorry. I was thinking it put it on 8, but it goes 4, then 7. No, wrong. Okay.
So we have to block here, right?
Yeah, of course. They have nothing. They pass priority. We have to play that.
Oh, okay.
We just need one spell. Okay. One spell.
Oh. All right.
Yep.
Right. Any one mana cost spell.
Yeah, don't do it now. Do it after the no blocks.
So we attack with both.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
No blocks.
Let them not block.
Okay. Off.
One mana cost spell.
Come on.
No! Double! You need to be more specific.
Okay.
Okay. Hang on. Can we cast it? No. Because if we rake and close. If we rake.
You have to.
What I'm saying is, could we cast it and then pay for it? But no, we won't.
No.
Sure. Okay. Okay. Come on. Give me one. Give me it.
It's torturous. Oh, it's torturous.
Okay, well, we tried.
I guess we do damage.
Yep.
Maybe we miscounted. Wait! No, we need double strike.
Yeah, we
need
double strike. Yeah, we could cycle into something.
Wait, we can cycle into one.
Yeah. And so, once again, we get an opponent to 1 and then lose. If only, you know what? I feel like this deck would be broken in half if you started on 19. If you started on 19, there would be no way to beat this deck. Unbelievable. All right, well. We're so close, boys. We're so close.
Always.
Okay. See if we can get him to slightly less than 1 this time. Hmm?
Just a tad below 1.
Like, we're not looking for it. We're not saying we want to get to, you know, like...
This is good.
20 less than 1 or anything. Just a little bit less than 1.
This is turn 3, right?
Does this have it?
Mm.
No, you need this to be an infuriate, but it's close.
Well... I didn't say we don't draw an infuriate. Come on.
All right, we'll keep this.
We should play Pact of Negation. Just a 3+3+0. Bam! Counter our own spell.
Legion's Landing.
There used to be... there is a 1-mana 1/2 that like exiles a spell from the stack.
Oh,
to gain +2/+2.
Niv-Magus Elemental. Yeah.
Yeah.
And there used to be a deck that actually like did that, like cast Pact of Negation and then just eat it up for,
well,
you know, for, like, you cast it for triggers on like Kiln Fiend and then you eat it so it doesn't counter your spell.
Yeah, and then you cast some storm stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, our opponent's on exactly 19.
This seems like a winnable game.
This
then.
Seems perfect. Yeah. Ooh.
That seems good.
We keep this, right?
Yeah.
Like, they're gonna have so many blockers otherwise. Man, whose idea was it to play Tetsuko?
Mine, here.
It was a very good idea. It was a
Mr.
very
Knight.
Good idea.
Mr. Knight.
Although we're getting polymorphed here.
Polymorphed? Oh, it's this deck.
It's the deck that we played, yeah.
It's this deck.
Our first historic deck.
Wasn't it? Was it the first one? I feel like we played...
I think so.
I feel like we'd played a couple more, but it was the first one where we just didn't lose, I think.
So we need to shock a token right now, right? That's what I learned from the last time we played.
Yeah, we just play Tetsuko Mitsawa.
No, we have to play Kiln Fiend, right?
Yeah,
but we have one in play.
Yeah, yeah, but I like this. We can go Kiln Fiend and then shock the token and attack, and then next turn Tetsuko. Yeah, I like this a lot.
No! Don't shock now. Don't. No, bad, Riley.
Ah, yeah, true.
What?
Tuffle is right. Yeah, just don't attack. Yeah, if they go for the polymorph and then we shock, like.
Ah, yes. Okay. So no attacks. Yeah, okay. Yep.
You remember how the math was so complicated? Like, imagine how complicated the math is if you don't know if you even have all your creatures.
So what's this, a Luka? Have they got the polymorph?
Oh, and we can even shock the if they actually, like, literally poly... Oh.
Yeah.
Toffel, you have such a big brain. I didn't think of that.
But that, what? That's what...
Didn't
isn't
you
that,
say
that's
that?
What, isn't that what you just meant? No. Tuffle?
Yeah, yes, that's exactly what
and
I meant.
And you didn't get it. Okay, all right.
No, that's exactly what I meant.
Yeah, of course. Yeah,
that's right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Guys?
Look at our perfect 1/2 blockers against all of this. So now do we shock anything?
No.
Just
no,
hold
no,
it.
We keep it.
Okay.
Shocking is not... Wait, are they dead? No, right? They take 8, 10. So shocking doesn't do anything. If we draw a land, we do 18. So shocking would actually matter.
No, we can just wait. We're not close to dead here. We've got an answer for the first polymorph. I think.
Well, there is a history popping. And they also have lifeling. Oh, no, they don't have lifeling, but they have a castle. So I guess we play Tetsuko.
Yeah, just Tetsuko and attack now.
No, now don't attack.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, we can't block because they die to any blocks.
Why? What?
Why?
Because of the castle.
Oh, the castle Embereth.
We could block with one. We can now. Just don't attack. It's fine.
Yeah. Man, our opponent, bloody unfair, cheating, playing lands that do spell-like things. You hate to see it. Well, now they can polymorph one of the knights.
Ooh. Oh.
So hopefully they don't see that line. No.
Maybe they don't.
They didn't see the line. And heroic reinforcements. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Okay. Well, we might be in trouble here.
No. It'll be fine.
It'll be fine.
I think it is fine. I think this is fine.
Wow. Okay.
So can we...
So we shock the 2-2 with lifelink. We block a 5-4. And that's 17. Yikes.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 14. Wow, that's a lot. 24.
Yeah.
So we have to block with one of the kiln fiends?
I think so.
Yeah, but we definitely need to shock the lifelinker.
Okay.
This is more damage than it looked like.
No, I don't think we need to shock a lifelinker. No. The correct play would have been to dive down one of the kiln fiends that blocks.
Okay. No, but that doesn't save him.
No, of course. We block 5-4, and then the kill fiend blocks 2-2-2s.
So what do you want to block here? One of the knights?
Now we kind of have to do this, right?
Okay.
Yeah, but this way we survive, 2, 4, right?
6,
yeah,
eight,
this way
10,
we take
14.
Go to 3.
So now we just need to draw infuriate or land.
I really hope we don't do 19 damage.
No, 18.
No, 9.
If we brick, we do 18. If we draw land or an infuriate...
How do you do 18?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. This
oh, yeah,
is just
you don't
the,
do 18.
This is the draw Wait, one, mana, the, one mana spell
why didn't
over
we,
again.
Why didn't we scry an upkey?
Oh, with Sam's Sprint.
Because then it wouldn't be unblockable anymore.
We can... the Tetsumo? Yeah, I guess.
Oh, man. All right.
Let's do 19 damage, guys.
So, is that what looks like?
No, we're actually doing 19. This is ridiculous.
Are we actually doing 19 again?
I think so.
Wait.
Oh, let's find out.
Pay two.
So, let's attack. Find out. No blocks. Samet Sprint this. Yeah. It's not 19, surely. No. Oh, it doesn't really matter.
12. It's 19.
Is it 19? Don't tell me it's 19. It can't be. Oh my goodness. Oh, are you kidding me? How has this happened 3 games in a row? We get them to 1. 3 games in a row. And now they didn't even bother hoofing us. The disrespect didn't even bother hoofing. Still had the looker, didn't bother hoofing us. Unbelievable. I think we just email Wizards and ask them to change the starting life totals. I mean, this year they changed the number of cards you start with in hand. So maybe we change how many life points we start with at the beginning of the game.
I think that was one on us. Was on us though.
What?
If we dive down the kill fiend, then block one of the 2-2s,
and
jump to the 5-4 with the 1-3, and then block. Don't block with the other thing.
Yeah.
Then we survive.
Okay, because they don't have a... And we can
shock. No, we still lose one of the kill fiends, right?
Yeah.
I don't know. Math is hard.
Math's very difficult. This is very good, actually. What do you want to flash back? The Samet Sprint?
I mean, yes.
Sure. Right?
Yeah. Can't splash back the spell Pierce.
Yep.
Aren't they the Dread Arcanist deck? Just saying.
So, let's... Yeah, I think we just play this in attack and scry, right?
But that doesn't change anything.
What? It lets us scry at the top card of our library. Find something. No?
No. I mean, they can still block the Arcanist because...
Why?
It has trample.
It gets trample? No.
It has trample. It's a one mana.
It has trample.
Yeah.
Big Brain is also playing Tetsuko and then giving Tetsuko haste and then really quickly trying to sneak it into the attacks.
Mm. Or
GG.
Wow.
A very bold strategy. This is the high level pro strats. You just bore your opponent to death with menial decisions. Easy. In fairness to our opponent there, they were pretty dead.
Extremely.
Like, they play an Archfiend's Vessel, then a Croxa. We played a 1-3. What were they going to do, right? All right, let's keep this. Seems fine. We're doing a little bit better with drawing creatures. Should we actually put the Sprite Dragon in Tuffle?
Yeah, maybe.
It does seem a little creature light, doesn't it?
I mean, maybe it's, yeah, no. The dive down is weird. It's very, what do you say, defensive, right?
Yeah.
It's not the style of the deck.
No, same with the spell pierce. You kind of like, they're there, you know, presumably to break up like a removal spell or something, but that's not really...
Yeah, most of the time you don't even have the mana to fight over removal spells because you just spend all your mana trying to...
Well, I mean, we're playing three of each. We could trim two and put in some Sprite Dragons or something. I don't mind doing that, actually.
I really hope they try to kill it now. We say that. Okay,
should we just get in for a stack, right?
Yeah. And like, if the second Infuriate also resolves, we can just go for Double Strike. Yeah, but now we have to dive down.
But the problem is now that we do 7 damage, but that's about all we do.
So, Tuffle, be grateful.
Yeah, be grateful maybe, for maybe 7 damage that we did. Wow.
Maybe we should have saved the Infuriate. Tuffle is right.
There are players around the world who would beg to do 7 damage, Tuffle.
Yeah, really.
And there are players around the world going, oh dear, okay.
Oh, wow. Ooh, okay. That's good.
So play this.
Yeah.
And then just, say go, right?
Yeah.
We could attack.
Could we?
Do you think they will block? Just flashback the dive... although we can do that next turn, too.
Why are we doing this?
We could flashback the dive
down. They will never block.
Yeah. Yeah, they won't block.
But we might want to dive down.
Yeah. Yeah, we might want to dive down our Killing Fiend next turn.
We can cycle this as well.
Yeah, just pass.
We can.
We just cast both of them... Like, if we cast both, they're dead, right?
Oh, right. Yeah, no, these stack. Because I was thinking, these are redundant, but they're not at all.
But only if they don't block the Kiln Fiend, which...
Even if they both get double strike, that's fine.
Okay, Magma Spray.
Well...
Can't tell you about that, right?
Okay, sure.
Okay. Now, imagine doing both of them on the Arcanist. Then it has double strike and 2 power.
Amazing.
Well, if we somehow get it... Another 2 power that's already dead, right?
No, take it.
Yeah. The problem is they might have some removal spells in hand.
I think we cycle this.
I think we cycle that now, yeah.
I think we cycle, guys.
Okay.
Good call.
Thanks for the input.
Ooh, they take a damage. Ooh, if we kill the creatures, they...
Oh, they take heaps from the Ferocidon, right.
This situation is not ideal. No. I would.
So we play land and say go.
I agree with your assessment, Jamin.
Thank you.
No attacks. So now we just take a clean 6 or probably more. Because they probably play something. They've probably got Torbran here, don't they? So always got it. They've always got it. Boys, have you noticed in my experience, they just always have it.
Wait, are we dead to Embercleave here? Yikes.
Probably right.
5, 6, 12. No, we're not.
Okay.
We're at 1.
No blocks. Cleave.
Easy game.
All right, there's the cleave.
There's
so now we just need now we just need 12 damage.
Infuriate or something?
Wait, why would you do...
Infuriate does it, right?
No. 4, 8, 13. That's even less. Why would you do that, my friend? Okay. Sometimes quite... Okay, one time.
Infuriate.
I really hope there's something that gives us 11 damage.
Come on. Come on. Yeah, if we can get to 11 here, come on, one time, give me it.
Oh, that's got to be it, right? That's got to be it. This has got to be it.
Yeah, it is.
Like, it has to be, right?
So how do we do 11?
We infuriate. No, how do we do 11? Yeah, we got to do 11. No, let's actually win a game. So, infuriate on this, right?
Yes, we double the power.
Don't do that now.
Why not?
That's 11.
Yeah. What?
No, we don't do the infuriate.
We can flash this back.
Yeah, no, do the infuriate. Do 11.
I'm not listening to you guys. I'm going to do the thing. All right. So,
yeah, okay.
Unleash Fury, 8, attack, flashback, the Unleash Fury.
It doesn't matter what you flashback, right? Because
exactly, do infuriate.
No.
Doesn't infuriate also get doubled? Isn't that how doubling power works?
No. Okay,
sure it is.
No, that's not pretty how it works. Sure. All right, we got there. We didn't reduce... despite the Jamin and Toffel's best efforts to get our opponent to one again.
I'm pretty sure...
I'm for real. I think that's how it works.
I don't know how our opponents paid you two off to try to... you two are a bunch of paid actors trying to get our opponent to one every time. Unbelievable. I'll keep this.
I think Jamin got confused with layers, as it's very understandable.
Oh, do you actually think... were you being serious, Jamin?
Yes, I was.
Oh, right. Okay, sorry. I thought you were just trying to make me lose.
You had like the bad angel and the nice angel, only the nice angel was stupid. Like
Yeah. Okay. No, so with some stuff...
Oh, this is good. Okay.
With some stuff, like if you switch power and toughness, then it can be weird, but with
and
doubling...
And it lingers on the card.
Yeah.
Okay, wow, they do nothing. Ah, they have seal. Oh, they have seal away. Oh, that's good.
Some kill and fame.
No. Oh, shit.
Why? We just play dive. Why? We still got dive down.
Yeah, we're not playing dive down now. Yeah.
Oh.
That's okay. No. That's actually fairly fine. That's really fine. Okay, so now we opt.
Yeah, no, but I mean,
No. Because then they steal away during their turn.
No, they don't. They don't. I tell you, just do it. It's fine. This is good.
So brutal, though.
Opt. Great. Good, we take right? opt. Yeah. We take opt.
This is.
I'm telling you, they'll steal away.
Even if it wins you the game, like getting censored and then having with a land in hand just feels terrible. Like even when it's the correct play, it still feels awful. Oh man, brutal.
Okay, are they dead now?
No, we definitely need a doubling thing, right?
Well, let's draw a doubling thing.
Okay, there's a doubling thing.
That's a doubling thing, but they're still...
So wait, we opt into a land and then we're good, right? That's the thing. We opt into a land.
Opt into a land, shock, unleash, fury, kill him. Is that
an easy game?
That's a battle plan? All right.
Please?
Opt into a land. Ding.
Please?
Yes. Oh, yes. All right.
Yes.
So land.
Yes,
play
yes,
this.
Yes.
Yeah, nice.
Shock them. And then unleash fury. And that's the turn 4 win. That's the turn 4 win that we've been getting just consistently every single time. Yeah. Hit you for 20.
Broken
don't
deck.
Even worry about it. Bam. This deck's broken. Welcome to the new historic. I have to say, that's more what I had in mind when wanting to play this deck. I just imagined it was going to be like, 10 games in a row just like that. Not so much the old, if we draw it, nope, okay, put him to one. Oh, put him to one again. Yeah, that was not necessarily part of the plan.
Ooh, right. That also looks good. Although Loras is kind of bad for us.
Because they can keep bringing back blockers.
No, they either play Auras, which is kind of bad because like we need to do a lot of damage if they play Auras. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Well, we'll just shock that.
No.
Not now, right?
No, I think you have to shock the O2. That's the only chance, really.
Oh, okay, sure. All right.
The one.
Core spirit dance, or whatever it is.
Like, if they play something on this now, we can shock it, but.
Yeah. Like a cartouche.
Ooh, a cartouche.
It's been a while since we've seen this slithery boy get it done, hey? Do we shock it anyway now?
No.
Oh, okay.
I guess.
I think we do now.
Now we have to show. I mean, but we're also never blocking, really, right? Like,
no, that's true.
It's like, what if we shock this now? Are we blocking other creatures? I think this is okay.
Okay.
I mean, yeah, shock might actually clear blocker at some point, so might as well keep it in hand.
Okay. Another slithery boy. All right. Sure. So kiln fiend this turn, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotta get the kiln fiend
and
online.
Then hope for the best.
Yeah.
We also got a lot of blue sources going on right now.
I mean, I don't think we can afford any more jewels, right? Because there's no other jewels that come to play untapped. All right, I'd like to block, please. What? Excuse me?
No blocks!
Oh. What?
Yeah, the deck is named No Blocks.
Oh, right, so that means we also can't block, I see. I didn't understand that. All right, yeah.
It goes both ways.
Yeah, it's one of those symmetrical effects. Oh, okay. Well, that's a good shock target.
Yeah, but they have the selfless.
Show me dive down. You control.
Oh, yeah, we can't give it hexproof. though that would counter the shock anyway. All right.
Well, I guess then we play a land and attack.
Just attack, right?
No blocks? Yeah, no blocks. All right. Infuriate?
So we dive down, right? Yeah, infuriate, and then we also dive down.
Just to push through damage?
Yeah, exactly.
I guess they don't play a bunch of removal, right? Well, then we can still keep up Spell Pierce that way, actually. It's not too bad.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Do you want to do that, Tovel?
Mm-hmm.
Signing off on this play?
Yeah, I was just thinking how we get through later, but we have to draw something then.
Oh. Yeah, so we'll cool. Just draw something.
Just draw something. Sava.
Right. Deal 10. I mean, they're dead next turn, based on this clock.
Based on my clock? That's the time difference, dude, between Germany and Scotland.
People would run a lot of fast 100-meter races or something.
Oh, I can't even spell pierce it. Gross.
Sure, just spell pierce it, and then they have to pay.
No.
Something.
This is plus 1+1, right? Like.
Yeah.
Well, it's +5/+5 or something because of this stupid thing.
No,
it's +3/+3.
+3/+3.
Yeah, but any other aura would.
Yeah, just let it resolve, and right. If they cast another thing, we can counter that.
We can spell.
Maybe the thing is, maybe they attack with. Ooh, that is interesting. Okay. Ah, no, that's so bad.
We can spell pierce it.
Yay! But they can cut. No. Yes.
Yay!
Can they cut? They can't.
They can't get it back
it.
Right now because they don't have any cards in their graveyard.
What I wanted to do is if they attack with Spirit Dancer, Slitherblade, and only leave the dog behind, we can shock the dog.
Yeah.
And then they sacrifice the dog, and then we can spell pierce the shock. So we get both triggers out of the spell
piece. Oh, so smart. Oh.
Whoa. Okay.
Okay.
All right. They like...
But
attack with all. Oh, wait. 1 second.
So if we draw a Tetsuko...
Okay. Well, we can opt here anyway. Right?
Yeah. Seems good.
If we draw red, we win... Yeah, if we draw a red, we win, right?
Because we can't, yeah. Because
right,
then we go shock, shock. They don't have any blockers.
Shock, shock, no block. Ugh.
That's no red.
That's not Please. Red. All right, come
Please.
On.
Riley.
Mount.
Colorblind.
Yes! Oh, yes! The clutch victory. All right, so now we go shock, shock, right?
Shock, shock, we win.
So shock the Slither Blade.
Yeah.
Or it doesn't matter, actually.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, just one of
shock
them.
Shock the Slither Blade. And then if they sacrifice the selfless savior.
Oh no, they have
they have
a spell?
Karamich's blessing.
Oh, that's rough.
This doesn't give trample. Okay. Do you want to kill the Slitherblade or the selfless savior?
We probably just have to pass. Like we probably just don't shock right now.
You don't think so?
Because like we can't attack this turn anyway.
Why not?
Oh, Karametra's Blessing only gives +2/+2.
But we can make sure that...
No, but if we shock, they give it indestructible.
Yeah, that's true. So the Karametra's Blessing does resolve.
Yeah,
I think we keep it.
Yeah.
As in we
and
just...
They always
just
have
it.
An indestructible...
Yeah.
No, not indestructible. But they always have... indestructible 3/4 blocker is what they have.
Okay, so just let this go?
Yeah.
Ugh. And then we might survive, and then Tetsu...
Then the Tetsuko on top just does the rest.
All right, so it's Tetsuko on top. We've already had one good peel.
Man. Yeah, I don't know if we're allowed two good top decks in one episode.
We've already had two, actually, because we had one of the previous games as well. So maybe we're already at our top deck limit here.
I mean, if you ask for one more, you can't really... You can't really, like, ask for five more.
You can. I mean, one more doesn't necessarily... Like, one more doesn't ban you from asking for another one more after that.
Yeah. Okay?
Or do you have to specify and say one or perhaps two more?
We kind of said only one per tournament. Then would be the question, what's a tournament in our sense?
Making this indestructible. What's going on here?
They're escaping the Sentinel's eyes.
Right. Okay, yeah. Very smart. Oh, Jamin, so smart.
Yeah, it seems like the Tetsuko on top has to do everything else.
Well, let's just draw Tetsuko then.
Yeah. I mean, with the admin interface.
I think it means that we get three, Toffle. We get one each. So we've already used two.
Yeah, that makes sense. That actually makes the most sense.
I think that's by the international duelist laws. So what do they think about putting us to one here?
Wasn't it duelist laws that you never duel, really? You just shoot into the air?
There were all... If you'd like to learn about that, you can go and listen to Half-Assed History.
Not again.
Thank you, Toffle, for the alley-oop there. Yes, go and listen to Hamilton versus Burr, where I talk about the rules of dueling, the code duello, which sounds made up. I mean, I guess it is made up. Like, humans just made it up.
Okay, Tetsuko for win, right?
All right, here we go. Tetsuko off the top. Half-Assed History.com. All right, here it is. Nope. Never mind. All right,
we're not dead, right?
We fought bravely. It does involve chump blocking, though.
We can double pump.
Oh.
Yeah, we can double pump trade and then die in two turns. It's literally the time.
what a delicious idea.
Okay.
All right, pack it up.
Say go.
We'll see if they attack. All right, let's go. Maybe they don't see that an attack.
Maybe they're afraid.
Gives me another chance to plug halfasshistory.net. We can go and find out about. Yeah, the code duello sounds like it's made up, but that was the name of the. Of the set of rules that governed people's duels. All right, all that glitters, away you go.
Toffle, what's your end game plan here?
Don't worry about it. Yeah, it's fine.
It's all coming together.
We'll get to that later.
Yeah, it's like in those films, it's like, I don't have time to explain. It's like, you definitely do. Let's just stop for 30 seconds, right?
Okay.
You do have time to explain.
So this is kind of tough now.
Okay.
If they have to. But it's fine. We're good.
Yeah, we're good?
Just wait for it, right?
Okay, all right, yep. So
they don't mind that they have a 6-power unblockable.
6-5 unblockable, yeah. Looking, no, it actually looks pretty good for us right now, actually. You know, Toffle, I have to agree. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Really good, actually. Now that they, like, draw cards, deck themselves.
Maybe they'll deck themselves, exactly. Yeah, we're getting close. 43. Okay, let's see if they attack. I wonder if they'll attack. I guess they're kind of priced into attacking, because otherwise the Curious Obsession falls off.
Yeah.
So they kind of have to.
So
let's see if they see the line.
Okay. We can block this. Easy. This is done.
So what's your plan for these two, Toffle? Because there's an empty block over here. So this is the point. No. Now it happens. Now Toffle, all of Toffle's mastery. So Toffle, reveal to us, please, your great plan.
Okay, we cast Infuriate on the last of the blade that isn't pumped.
This one here?
Yeah.
Yes. Are you sure?
Are you sure?
Are you sure? Okay, so that makes it a 7-2. Nope. Toffle, I have to... Yeah, I don't want to blame you, mate, but it seems like something went a little off there for you.
You know how they do like speed runs and they find glitches? I really hope that this very sentence getting directly into the kill screen.
Right.
Got us into this kill screen.
Well, this deck seems enormously swingy. It seems to... Well, actually, no, we've had all sorts of results, haven't we? We've had like kill them easily. We've had put them to one. We've had lose terribly.
We had a second turn kill.
So let's spin the wheel and see how we go for one more.
One more.
Ding 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 ding. Oh no, we haven't even found a match yet. I'm sorry.
Yeah, every time.
I didn't want to annoy anyone with.
No, you certainly avoided that. Don't worry about that. The jingle gets better every week. Toffle, I really like the idea that what you were talking about before was because in speedruns, if anyone's a fan of speedruns, and you go and watch speedruns, just pick your favorite game and type in the game's name and then speedrun to YouTube because it's amazing. But a lot of the time, there's all these like little weird.
Do it, like, because if you're really, really stupid, once you see what people do.
What do you mean?
Like, I remember playing Final Fantasy VIII, right? Yeah, and then saw a speedrun out of it, and they explained like so many things about what you should and shouldn't have done. And I was like,
right. Oh, yeah, I'm so dumb. Yeah. Well, if you want to watch like Ocarina of Time speedruns or Mario speedruns or stuff, they actually or Pokemon, they actually hack the game by like just moving walking character around. Do we keep this?
Probably not.
Actually,
like if we find a red source,
although I guess if we find another land, we win.
It's a turn three kill, right? So we keep this.
Yeah, we have shock for blockers.
Yeah, no, that's not it. All right, never mind. So play this.
So this is good.
If there was some ways, like, oh, if you click here and play this combination of cards and then, like, emote your...
Wait, what?
Ooh. Do we accidentally parent Q into Limited? What's going on?
What?
What?
I mean, they really hate flyers?
What?
Maybe they really don't want to lose against Mono Blue.
Let's see if they block.
Yeah, let's see if they block.
Because if they don't block, we win.
Wait, do we?
Yeah, in Fury, Unleash Fury. That's 20 damage. Okay. This is the test, boys. This is the test. I said that this deck was based around people not blocking. They blocked.
But it's fine. No,
but we just shocked their face, right?
We opt.
What?
We opt.
Oh, just opt.
Yeah, we opt. We want to find more stuff.
Wait, what does this spider...
Ooh, that's good.
This seems good.
No. A land is better, right? A land also kills if they play anything.
Because we didn't have shock. Yeah, true.
Okay.
Yeah, shock does get rid of most blockers.
Yeah, until they play Giant Spider.
What is... Like, I'm so baffled. What happened?
Well, I guess Giant Spider does to Shock, actually. I'll
like they actually queue with your limited deck somehow?
Look, I'm as baffled as you are, Toffle.
Like, if we wouldn't record, like, on a secret base, right? Like, I would assume somebody streams now.
All right. Play the land and let's go.
Let's go.
Okay, is there any card that makes us lose? Like from
not to damage.
So
don't click next.
Infuriate.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, yeah, I guess they have nothing.
We don't even need to cast another Infuriate. We can just unleash Fury.
No, we go for damage.
Oh,
no,
we go for the max. Right.
The maximum damage. Sorry, everyone. Sorry, what was
is
I thinking?
Just asking 13... for a friend.
Is there what?
Fog in this forest.
There are several fogs, but not today. Yes!
Wow.
Hit him for 32. Oh dear. Well, I described this deck as swingy, and that's certainly. I mean, I guess the good news here, boys. The good news is 100% win rate against Snare Spinner aggro. So that's very good. Well, even if we didn't get anyone with the old no blocks Kiln Fiend, this deck certainly was. It really put on a show, didn't it? We had the heart wrenching, so close. Get them to one games at the beginning and then, just crushing Snare Spinner aggro, which I know people... That matchup I know a lot of people are worried about, so it's good to see that this deck absolutely crushes it.
I would say not for the faint of heart.
Yes.
First of all. And then it got definitely the Arena Boys certified better than expected.
Better than expected, yes. Yes, it did get better than expected.
Yeah.
Now, I'm very sorry to the person who originally had this deck. I mean, I know a lot of people have been playing with Kiln Fiend for a long time. But I remember I came across this on Magic subreddit where someone posted a highlight video of themselves playing with this deck, and they basically collated or compiled all of the instances where people didn't block Kiln Fiend and then immediately died. So it's great entertainment, and be sure to go and have a look at it. It's if you search for Kiln Fiend on Reddit, you'll be able to find it. But yeah, this is a this is a very silly, very fun deck. Do we want more creatures? Do you think we maybe like shave a dive down a spell pierce and put in some sprite dragons or?
Maybe it felt like you don't really need all of those defensive mechanisms.
No, not really. And you know, I think maybe we're on the bad side of variance to begin with, but it isn't playing a lot of creatures. Like we didn't draw minute. Maybe we were either unlucky to begin with or lucky.
We were rather lucky in the end.
Yeah, I think having a couple of extra threats would be very useful. Even if Sprite Dragon doesn't go too well with Tetsuko, it's still fine. It's got flying, so. Yeah, maybe whack some Sprite Dragons in there. Anyway, Zendikar fast approaching, my friends. We're going to wrap it up here. So be sure to send in your Zendikar brews. Already there are a fair few cards that have been previewed that we're licking our chops over.
Oh, yeah. In the flavor text, it says Arena Boys.
Arena Boys. Made for really? The Arena Boys. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Go and have a look. Oh, I'm not going to tell you. I mean, that'd take the fun out of it. Give you a chance to go and find it for yourself, but it's quite hidden as well. Like, you have to do a little bit of decoding, like look at every second letter with every third
number. There's a white creature with life gain that wins the game no matter how much life your opponent has. If that doesn't, it's not for us, like, I don't know.
Yes, alternate win conditions, all about it. We're all about it. So send in your brews, send in your list. The best place to do this, of course, on the Discord, bit.ly/join Riley's Discord. There's a decklist submission channel there, so send in your brews for Zendikar, because I think, is it next week? No, the week after. Is it next week or next, the week after?
Well, probably the week after.
I'll have to check that. Anyway.
Next week is the invitation. When this comes out, week.
Yeah, I think by the time this comes out, it'll be next week. I'm not sure. I'm not sure of the exact dates, but soon. It'll be soon. So do send in your brews and we'll have a look through them, select the very finest. And in the meantime, make sure to jump on Twitter, follow us all, at the Arena Boys for the show, or at Riley Crutale for me.
At Telflam the G for me.
And at Jacko Mattress for Jamin.
You can also go
myself
to my dumb...
For J-A-M-I-N.
Hufflesissue.net if you want to go and listen to my Instagram.
what was this?
I feel like the outro has just become it's just a whole mess all the time. Like, just...
No, we need more. You know?
Need more. More of a mess. Well, what have you got to plug? Couple?
Arena Boys, Arena Boys, the Arena Mythic Invitational this
the
weekend.
Arena Boys Invitational would really be something.
Well, I got invited, so that's Arena Boys Invitational, right?
Arena Boy.
The Arena Boy Invitational.
Yeah, the Arena Boy Invitational, yeah. Wait, is Gabe Nassif playing? This is the fake Arena Boy?
No, yeah.
Oh, so there are two Arena Boys, one real, one fake. Well, top
you can watch Damon's Robots... on Twitter, yeah. JaminRobot.com.
JaminRobot.com.
Right, that's now, it's Lego project building Mario. How far are you with the Fall Boys cover of your Lego system?
Very far. It's like it's right up there with the deck you're supposed to build.
If you take the figure and drop it, it falls.
Perfect.
All good.
Yeah, and now you just need some that sort of like hover around in the air and frustrate everyone, or can run really way, way faster than everyone else.
If you put a figure on like the middle of your board and then take a huge ball and throw it against it, it's basically what I did.
All right, well, be sure to go and check out arenaboys.com. No, what was it? JaminRobot.com. That's right. JaminRobot.com. And we're done. Thanks for tuning in, sending those lists, and we will see you next week. It's time to exit the arena.
Boys!